Well, one of the scenes that comes to mind immediately is a youngster that has been born in the group, and they have the night cages where they are kept, can be kept in isolation. And the mother is sitting high up in the cage and looking down at that screaming little black thing that is down in the hay. And so in that case, in these times, later on, it became much more easy. But at that time, we had to take out often a chimpanzee from the colony, and these were hand-reared. We had quite a few, I think, altogether in the course of the years. We have raised 5 or 6 chimpanzees in our home, and one gorilla. And our kids were, at that time, were about 4. The eldest, the youngest was about 3-4 years old. The eldest was 5-6 years old. And they played with the chimpanzees, and it was a quite natural thing. They rushed in our house, and that all went. Beautiful scenes, but also quite a bit of sacrifice indeed. And we realized after about a year they had to go. For two reasons. It becomes much more difficult to keep them in the house because you must close them up, because otherwise they run about the place and they are not always very careful with the furniture and things. And the second thing was that you didn't want to have them specialized in human beings and adapted to human beings, so they had to be reintroduced in the group and preferably with other youngsters in juvenile groups to grow up together. But it meant that we had quite a few chimpanzees in the home. Yeah, I mean, you interact with the animals just normally, I would say, and the chimps react normally. And obviously there's a great mutual understanding because we are not that different. And the same as we deal with dogs, not with bulls, by the way, but with dogs, there is a common rapport, and that is also the case with these chimpanzees. So we had a few of them in the home, but eventually they had to move out. Yeah.
Was there a big difference between the baby gorilla that you raised and the baby?
Oh yeah, baby gorilla and the baby chimpanzee, completely different, characters, and. Chimpanzees are the great extroverts. They scream and they do, because gorillas are much more calm, etc. And in a way, much more manageable. But it was, of course, always great fun. Great fun. My wife used to, when I was at the institute, she was with the with her own children who went to school, and with the chimpanzee. And we had the chimpanzee, we had a kind of box where the chimpanzee could sleep, and then you could take out. But she would take, especially when they were still quite small, she would take them in a pram and walk to the shops and go shopping and leave the pram outside and be a little bit covered so that people didn't see what was in. But people nevertheless looked at it and thought, if she a baby, and suddenly saw something quite different, which looked like an abnormal child, or what is that? Didn't understand what it was. So you had people nevertheless react sometimes very crazy. In this country, we do a lot of cycling, as you know, but not race cycling also, but family cycling, that kind of thing. And you may have seen children in front and at the back and not wearing any helmets. Americans think that we are absolutely crazy. This is a risk they would never take. But then we went cycling in a beautiful autumn day, which I remember with the gorilla. That was during autumn that we did that. And she had, it was a, was it a she? Oh, I forgot now. Anyway, the gorilla had a little coat, baby clothes on, because it could be cold, and sat in front when we cycled in the front, and loved it. And then we cycled along cycle tracks through the woods, and then other families came from the other direction and came cycle, and they greeted us and looked at us, and then we passed by, and then often we heard, when they were 10, 20 meters past, you heard, "Oh, hey, did you see that? What was that?" And they suddenly realized that they had seen something very strange. A little black face in a capuchon on that. But it was not it. What was it?